Alright, so hello everyone on YouTube. I hope everyone's doing well. You can't see my lovely, lovely face because of a video we're watching. We need the subtitles. The spoken language is Japanese, and no matter where I put my webcam, it's always in the way of something you want to watch. So this is going to be like one of those, you know, director commentary tracks on those old school DVDs. I will just be talking over the action. So let's go. This is a developer's diary from Bandai Namco on the development of Leroy Smith and Fakumram. So this is going to be very, very interesting. We will hear some additional details about Fakumram. Not a lot is known right now. And of course, Leroy Smith, a monumental success if you, you know, take the balancing and his gameplay out of it. But animations are great and, you know, visually he's second to none. Almost, I want to say. He's just a fantastic design.
Season 1, Season 2 とゲストキャラクター作ってきて、Season 3になって、やっぱり鉄拳としての新キャラクター作りたいと思いすごい開発にもあって、まあ、だったら昔からテコンドー、カポエイラとか含めて、実在の格闘技にこだわって新キャラクター作ってきたので、キーワードとしてはやっぱり武術の達人をもう一回出そうっていう思いがある。
So this is something, sorry, I'm pausing very quickly here, but he said that we wanted more grounded martial arts, you know, rather than, well, take your pick, you know, Alisa, Eliza. And I'm so happy with this because many of us remember the old school Tekken, you know, the early games where everyone planted both of their feet to the ground and fought using roundhouse kicks, hook kicks, you know, jabs. And lately, it's been a lot of flying around, doing invincible attacks and cartwheels and basically matrix moves. You've seen this happen in Resident Evil as well. You know, older games, people are grounded. And then Resident Evil 4, Wesker's doing a double backflip while shooting. And, you know, it's just the technology has gone so far in terms of animation that people just want to push those boundaries in terms of, you know, how crazy acrobatic everyone is, you know, and characters start flying. So I much prefer going back to old school martial arts, and I think everyone is really enjoying that. And that's one of the most appealing things about Leroy is that it's just basic cool Wing Chun.
ジンの本物の空手になった段階もあったり
とか、Exactly.
評判良かったし、
でそういうのはやっぱもうちょっとそういうの見たいなっていう声が多かったかなって、海外で本当にかっこよくて強くて、みんなの聞いたことある格闘技を
It's great to hear that they actually acknowledge, you know, the thoughts and opinions of the community. And of course, that's what we're doing at this very moment with Leroy's very apparent brokenness. They will address it with patches. I will be talking more about that in a separate video. Oh, that design is simply amazing. I had the same reaction when you watch, when you look at that paper with all of his concept art. Though this one just really stands out.
服とか脱いだ時の入れ墨とか、本当もうアメリカ人の血が騒いで、ね、ああピンときた、これかっこいいって
同じ彫り師にどんどん年を追うごとに足していってもらって、あのデザインに仕上がったっていうようなコンセプトで作ってるんだけど、やっぱり裸も含めてリロイのかっこよさっていうのが表現できるようにしたいっていうのがあって、ああいうディティールを足したんだけど、やっぱり開発的には、まあ、一番近くにいる、まあ、プレイヤーにも近いプロデューサーであるマイケルさんがかっこいいって言ってくれるようなものであれば間違いないねっていうので、
そ
してもう完璧に今かっこいいって言ってくれたから、まあ結果良かったんだろうなと思うけどね。まあ、リロイは実在の武術である、まあ、英春拳をモチーフにしたキャラクターで、まあ、今回モーションキャプチャーにもねすごくこだわって作ったキャラクターだよね。
うん、英春拳は前から結構海外特に
I like the shot of the guy's ass to the left there in that yellow tight suit. What is that? Is that a Marvel hero? Bumblebee. No, I don't know. Just a lovely shot to have him in frame there as we're filming the display. Like, oh, mocap guy, can you please stand there so we can see your very tight ass?
初めてエボで公開したトレーラーもあの木人と叩くってこうやってやってるところから始めようっていうトレーラーの構成からあの考えた時に道場から木人
をキャッチャーサ
ジに運んでくれて、ね、実際にシェフが
beautiful mocap there and so cool that they actually brought in a Wing Chun master to record that、for his、intro there.And you heard him say there that they even recorded the sounds of him hitting the wooden dummy, and that's what you hear during that intro. So the attention to detail, you know, it's really there. And yeah, it's like from the very first trailer you saw of. Sorry, I'm gonna pause there so we don't miss anything. But from the very first trailer you saw of Leroy, it's like, holy shit, this can be great.And when the character reveal trailer came at Tekken World Tour, it's like you saw all of the intro, win poses, and his animations in-game, and it's like, god damn it, you know, this is exactly what I was expecting. All of the cool Ip Man stuff, and beautifully animated or mo-capped, as it always is with the Tekken characters, you know, it doesn't look like Mortal Kombat. In-game, Tekken looks great. But obviously, lately, there's a big shadow over the character, and it's the fact that his game... Did he just hump? No. It's just the fucking overpoweredness of a character that is an issue.
あの武器の要素入れたいねって話をして最初にあのリロイがこう持ってた杖
あれデザインカラー
だそうデザインが杖だったんだけどあの英春拳の中に6点半コンってい う, こう棍棒みたいな武器があってその棒を使った攻撃方法をあの英春拳の道場のシフにやってもらってたんだけど、うん、それをなんとかやっぱゲームにも入れたいってなった時にあちょうど杖があるじゃねえかってなってあれをこう可動式 の, あの伸縮性のある武器に見立ててゲーム中に1回だけ使える技として入れようぜっていうのもね結構やっぱデザインと
して It's such an interesting gimmick you know having a move that can only be used once but unfortunately making it plus 8 on block was a problem basically an extra rage drive you can use at any time but if you tone it down it's a very interesting mechanic
アフリカ系アメリカンとかいわゆる黒人のコミュニティの人たちからやっぱり作ってる僕らが日本人だから音楽面での期待はできないんじゃないかとか、まあ、ラップを表現してほしいという要望がたくさん SNS で上がってて、まあ、そういうオーダーを、まあ、原さんが僕らに、音楽で何かできないかっていうような話をして
I mean, come on, it's not that hard to find rap music, but...
と思ってあの曲を作って、まあ、実際ね、あの黒人のラッパーの人に歌ってもらってあの曲をね
And got an African American rapper to perform the song. Not a white one. Very important to point that out.
お前は解決しようとしているって出てそれがあの5行ぐらいお前は解決しようとしているお前は解決しようとしているお前は解決しようとしているこれ何のことだよってすごい笑ったよ
実は叩きのめしてやるみたいな意味なのに
そう Yeah, the song is actually really, really good
最初ね、あの実はかっこいいビットボール作ってたんだけどなんかやっぱりこれじゃねえなと思ってもう少しアホっぽい感じしてくれっていういろんなこう画像を検索して
Oh, she, Sugar is female. Didn't know that.
そこがやっぱりその実際出来上がったシュガーをあのトレーラーで公開した時にみんな喜んでくれてて、結果良かったんじゃないかなと思って。
で、
Oh, right, where there's no ball sack. Wow, why didn't I think about it? Otherwise, in that victory pose there, where, when Sugar runs to a back turn Leroy, you'd have testicles bumping up and down. Yeah, that would be a problem, I guess. Okay, Fakum Ram. Okay, no, exactly. And it's obvious that is what they were going for, especially when you look at all of the concept art, like intimidating, scary as fuck. You don't even want to approach that guy. You know, you don't want to be in the same building as him, basically. But the problem is, when you look at the concept art, in my opinion, they are way scarier looking Fakum Ram designs that they didn't use. They decided to obviously go with the one they chose, and in my opinion, one of the weaker designs. He's over 2 meters tall. The tallest Tekken character to date. I mean, I honestly thought that Miguel was like 2 meters, or Marduk, 2 meters. So at above 2 meters, he's the tallest Tekken character to date. Oh, so I'm almost as tall as Marduk at 6'3". God damn, I'm a fucking beast. Why am I not a DLC in Season 4? Oh shit, that's a cool detail. He was struck by lightning, and that's why he has those scars. The Lichtenberg. Way over the top. These ones are the best, in my opinion. That is very menacing. That's not only a very tall, you know, and muscular monster with scars and tattoos, that is someone who looks like downright scary compared to other Tekken characters. And he would very much have set himself apart from the other characters. He would have, that look in a Tekken game would have really stood out. But unfortunately, they didn't go for that, and they went with something, I would say, a tad more conventional. So that's that is unfortunate, in my opinion. I would have preferred that. But it's like we have so many attractive characters in Tekken, and it's like with the design way they went for it, Fakum Ram, he says there he has an intense glare, you know, a scary stare. But if you remove the tattoos and the scars and the, you know, the evil stare, whatever, you have a pretty good looking guy in Fakum Ram, you know, underneath it all, you can easily tell. And I would have much more liked to see a character who looked a little bit more like an ogre, you know, a proper monster. We have so many good-looking people in Tekken. Try and diversify it by going in the opposite direction. So that hurts my heart a little bit that they didn't do that. Kazumi's tiger. Maybe Kuma.
ガルーダの文字、入れ墨入れたのが一番効いたかなと思ってて、あのキャラの特徴の一つで、登場シーンでもあのヘリのこのハッチがこう開いたらこっからガルーダが見えてくるっていう意味がわかんないようなトレーラー演出をしてね、自分自身が燃えたやってるから、ようやく
やりたいものができたっていう感じだったね。たまたま横浜の入ったジムが実はすごい強い選手ばっかりが揃ってて、うん、吉成名高ってあの初めて日本人で、うん、ルンピニとラジェダンナの両方タイトル取った人がいて
所属してんだよね、
はい、その中の、実はそのモーションキャッチャーに一人使ったもんね。
そうでびっくりした。そんな人ブッキングできるのってね。
ね、あれは実はスワキン PK 戦隊選手だけど、
うん、Oh nice。
で那須川天心と戦って、
そうそうそう、ね、ライジンとか
に勝ったんですよね。 Fuckum Ram also more capped of course。
その人が、awesome. 使えるよって言ったら中津がマジかってそっから急発信したよね。
そうそうそう、いやだったらぜひねキャプチャー頼みましょうよ。
You can really feel the weight behind Fakum Ram's kicks and punches and how he rotates his hips and shoulders. Very nice detail.
ゲームならではの動き、うん、そのもうちょっと、トリッキーな動きができる、
アクロバティックな動きができる人が、ナダカ選手をキャプチャーの時にね、ナダカ呼べる。
Oh no, we need acrobatics. Come on, guys. That's what we don't need.
チャンピオン来るのみたいな。
そう、アニメーターすごい興奮してたよ ね、
すごい。だからいいモーションが取れたと思うし、ファーカムラムの中身にはなんとスアキムと吉成名高くんのキャプチャーが使われてるっていうね。
豪華なもの
だ
よね。
すげえ豪華な、今までないぐらい豪華だと思う。
俺のメインキャラになれる予定なんで、本当早く急いで急いで
こういう時だけ急いでって、サウンドチームからムエタイの試合で使ってる楽器を入れよう。でもやっぱり楽器使おうってなった時に日本で演奏できる人いなかったんですよ。
なかなかいないよね。
そしたらサウンドチームのつてで実はタイに在住してる大学の教授。
As always, it's incredible to hear the amount of detail that goes into just making one trailer or one character or one stage. But when you see it, you know, Attack on World Tour, you see his reveal trailer, you don't really think too much about it. All you're thinking is like, is this cool? Is this hype? Is the music good? You know, does the character look cool? Can he do big combo? What's the rage art? What's the rage art?But if you really, really look 100%, there's just so much detail. If I find any bugs.No, Murray, you won't find bugs. You'll just find a lot of overpowered moves with Leroy, unfortunately. But certainly they will learn their lesson when it comes to Fakum Ram, I think. But so that was really, really cool to watch. So interesting to hear them talk about all the tiny, tiny little details that all will come together to make a new character. I wish we had more of these.To see other great characters, or like, is there one of these on Negan? I'd love to see that as a fan of Walking Dead. Well, the old Walking Dead, at least. So, very interesting. I know we're all looking forward to Fakum Ram, and thankfully they will be nerfing Leroy pretty soon. We will talk about that as well. So thanks for listening to me, and I'm gonna link this in the YouTube comments in case you want to watch it without listening to my disgusting voice.